Hey everybody. The fish that you're looking at in this bag are called Ottos, which is short for Otocinclus. And they are a type of catfish that are native to South America. They're rather small, and they don't really get much bigger than a couple of inches. And they have this little mouth. It's kind of an underslung mouth. And it looks like a sucker. Like a sucker. And that's why they sometimes call these fish dwarf suckers or sucker mouths. I picked these guys up to help out with the algae problem that I've been having in my tank. And I pronounce it algae, and I've always called it algae. My friends across the pond call it algae, and I'm not sure which is the correct pronunciation. So I'll just continue to call it algae for now anyhow. And this little guy is sitting on the bottom of the tank. And as you can see, I've removed the substrate and it's just a glass bottom. And you see the little sucker mouth? These guys, they attach themselves to whatever they can. They're used to living in rivers that have quite a bit of current. So they're very used to just kind of hanging there in the breeze, so to speak. These fish are widely distributed east of the Andes of South America and throughout the lowlands from northern Venezuela to northern Argentina, and they're generally not found in the Amazon or the Orinoco lowlands. Some of the things that I've read about Ottos is that they're really poor acclimators, meaning that they don't handle change very well. Changes in water temperature or water parameters or the stress from being transported. So after you get these guys home from the pet store, the first 24 hours are the most critical. And then after that, the first week. And if they survive a month, well, they're likely to live a normal lifespan, which is 2 to 5 years, provided that their water is partially changed weekly and that the tank is kept clean. Now when you get these guys home, you know, they're in a little plastic bag, and you should float the bag in the aquarium water and let the temperature of the bag water equalize to the temperature of the water in the tank. And then you should start adding a little bit of water from the tank and putting it into their bag. And this is called drip acclimating. I use one of my wife's kitchen spoons to do this. And that's between you and I. Now this is the tank that they will be going into. This is my community tank. And here they are in the net, ready to be released into the community tank. They've been in the quarantine tank now for a few days. And they appear to be healthy. So I'm going to release them into the tank with the other fish. And there they go. And as you can see, immediately one has found a nice comfortable resting spot on a leaf, and another has attached himself to the glass. And in this shot you can see three of the four fish, one on the plant and two on the glass. And there's a young teenage platy coming to check them out, wondering who these newcomers are. And there's one of her sisters also being inquisitive. And back to drip acclimating. Like I said, you slowly add aquarium water to the bag water. And once I feel like half of the water in the bag is from my aquarium, that's when I think it's time to go ahead and net the fish and put them in the tank. And like I mentioned, if you have a quarantine tank, it's best to use that rather than taking a fish home from the pet store and just dumping him into the community tank and possibly taking a chance at disease being passed on to your other fish. And here's a Papa Platy. And there's a couple of the Cory catfish that you may remember from another one of my videos. Everything has been going pretty good in the tank. Other than the fact that I have some algae growing, or algae. And that's the whole reason that I bought the Ottos, to help out on that problem. Because the Ottos really do love algae, that is what they mainly eat. And unfortunately, I've read that they do a very good job of taking care of the algae. But basically, they eat themselves out of food. So, as a supplement, you can buy, there's one of the little Cory catfish. As a supplement, you can give them algae wafers. But what I plan to do is set up what you call an algae farm. I read that I can take an old fish bowl and place a couple of small jars into the fishbowl along with some aquarium water, and just put it in the sun, and algae will grow all over the jars. And then I can take one of the jars and put it in the fish tank, the aquarium, and the Ottos, like this guy right here, will have a nice constant supply of algae. And after they pick the jar clean of algae, I can simply remove the jar and put in another jar. There's Mama Platy taking a peek from her house to see what's going on. And there's an Otto. Now you can also give these guys fresh vegetables. You can give them a strip of cucumber or zucchini and place it right into the tank, and they will munch on that. But I read that it's best to remove the vegetable after 24 hours so as to avoid a nitrate spike because of the vegetable rotting. So I am really looking forward to a algae-free aquarium. And in the future, I will give you an update on just how well these guys perform. I mean, this one is already working. These are definitely working fish. And there's the Daddy Platy and the Mama Platy. And you may recall their children that you see in the background. In one of my videos, the children were just probably a half a centimeter long. And now, these guys, they've really grown. And even the Cory catfish seem to have gotten a little bigger. So, overall, I've been very happy with this, with my return to this fish-keeping hobby. It's one of the Corys resting. And there's one of the Ottos resting on a plant. There's the Mama Platy. If you are new to my channel and haven't seen any of my aquarium videos, the tank is a 29-gallon tank. It's a, I think they call it a bio cube. And it's about half of the plants are real and maybe the other half are plastic. There's a little feeding frenzy going on. And I do love the Cory catfish. So I appreciate you watching this video, and I will do some update videos in the future. So once again, happy fish keeping, and thanks for watching.